You've probably heard NordVPN being called the most popular VPN this year. So if you're thinking about trying it, let me show you how to use NordVPN to its fullest. From getting started to making use of unique features, I will cover everything you need to know in this full NordVPN tutorial 2025. So if you don't have a subscription yet, it's not rocket science. Just click the link in the description to get the best NordVPN coupon code of 2025. It is going to auto apply the latest discount, so you'll see the best possible price. Then go through the sign up process, and that is step one of the Nord setup tutorial already done. Step two, download the NordVPN app, either from their official website or an app store. I've got the Mac one for this tutorial as it currently has all the latest NordVPN updates live, but there are apps for Windows, mobile, Linux, smart TVs, as well as browser extensions, and they all work very similarly. Plus, you can use NordVPN on 10 different devices at the same time. Well, probably not all by yourself, but you can share the account with your family and friends. Finally, step three is to log into the app. And now we can get started with learning how to use NordVPN basics. If you just want to initiate the VPN connection for online privacy, click the quick connect, wait a couple of seconds, and bam, you'll be connected to the closest, fastest server. If you want a specific location, choose it from the countries list on the side or just utilize the search bar. You're gonna need it as there are more than 7,000 servers across 120 plus countries. While I'm recording this video at least, I swear they keep changing the number every single day. But at least it always remains a big server fleet with lots of locations to choose from. Besides the regular servers, NordVPN also has specialty ones for specific use cases. For increased privacy protection, you can either use double VPN or go hardcore with the onion over VPN connection. If you don't see the latter, just head to NordVPN settings and change the protocol to one of the OpenVPN options. But otherwise, I recommend sticking with Nord links as it provides the fastest connection with modern encryption. There's also dedicated IP, which you have to pay for additionally, but you get your own personal IP address that nobody else can use, so you'll encounter fewer blocks while trying to browse or stream. And then there's P2P for torrenting, but we're gonna talk about torrenting and everything else you can do with the app a little bit later on. Before that, I want to share some tips and tricks that you can use to make your whole NordVPN experience smoother and easier. First off, if you're getting it for constant privacy protection, like to hide your browsing habits from your ISP or looking to bypass network restrictions, I recommend going into settings. Here in general settings, enable NordVPN to be launched at startup and then also set up auto connect. I also strongly suggest turning on the kill switch. It's going to cut off your internet access if something happens to the VPN connection, so your IP and data will always stay protected. If you want to make sure that your VPN connection is working properly, there's a NordVPN DNS leak tester. See if this information doesn't match your actual DNS addresses, which you can find by reloading the page without the VPN connection on. In the same way, you can use the ipleak.net website to check both your IP and DNS for leaks. But to be fair, I haven't seen or heard of a case where NordVPN would leak any of these. They are very solid on that front. And that's one of the reasons why I am confident in recommending it. So if you still don't have the NordVPN app, definitely give it a try. You can get it through this QR code or check the description for a special discount. But now let's continue this NordVPN tutorial 2025 with some specific stuff, like how to use NordVPN for streaming. In this case, you only need to choose a country, connect to it, and then turn on the streaming service. NordVPN has a built-in smart play technology which adjusts your DNS settings to get through to content more easily. So this usually works without any issues. I didn't notice anything off this time either, but it does require some light troubleshooting from time to time, like switching the server or clearing my browser cache. As for torrenting, folks, to secure your connection, select one of the specialized P2P servers, and you can also configure your torrent client to use a free SOX 5 proxy provided by NordVPN. Just keep in mind that this way you'll lose out on the encryption benefits. Oh, and the next feature is also a great thing to keep on, whether you're torrenting or just browsing. Introducing Threat Protection Pro. You can find it in the NordVPN sidebar or the dashboard, and you'll need to follow the setup guide to fully enable it. This tool has three layers. One, it blocks annoying ads and trackers. It is really effective on this front, and not just on regular banners, but on pop-ups and video ads too. Two, it checks websites for scams, malware, and phishing attempts. For this, it was even certified by AV Comparatives, while AV Test declared it as the best anti-malware solution amongst other VPNs with similar features. And layer number three is a full-on malicious file detector, which specifically checks the files that you download. This extensive protection is so far only for Windows and macOS users, and it works without a VPN connection. If you plan to use NordVPN on mobile or any other platform, you'll see the non-pro version of threat protection. It still blocks ads, trackers, and malicious URLs, but requires a VPN connection to work and won't scan your downloads for threats. At least for now, I'm hoping to see the pro version expand out to all the other operating systems. Another standout feature is Meshnet. It's also in the sidebar right here, or the main dashboard. It essentially acts like a remote LAN with the added benefit of encryption, so you can securely connect devices across the world if you wish. For, I don't know, say a remote LAN party, or just accessing your own PC files from abroad. Well, given you keep your PC on, that is. That said, the setup can take a bit of effort, but NordVPN guides you through the whole process. And it's pretty cool that it's completely free, whether you have a subscription or not. And then you have the dark web monitor tool right here in the sidebar, or again, you can access it through the dashboard. This one is a set and forget kind of deal, but in a really cool way. You add which of your email addresses you want monitored, confirm it from the email side, and NordVPN will notify you if your info ever appears on dark web. This way you can take action right away, change your password on the affected accounts, and prevent hacking attempts. And that's all the necessary things you need to know to make the most out of NordVPN. Of course, there are more settings, mostly little things like appearance, but everything in the app is explained, and all of that stuff is fully optional anyway. If anything, feel free to ask questions in the comment section. I will help you out as much as I can. I hope this VPN for Beginners tutorial helped you out. And if you still don't have a NordVPN subscription somehow, don't forget to grab a discount from the description. Cheers.